Thank you and welcome to the show this morning. The topic this morning is the psychological impact of slavery on African Americans. And we have to talk about the psychological impact of slavery on African Americans, Mrs. Karen Shakir. Mrs. Shakir will give us some information about her background, her education, and some of the things that prompted her to deal with this issue of the impact of slavery on African Americans. And of course, Mrs. Shakir, let me welcome you to the show this morning.
Thank you so much, Dr. Haney. Thank you.
And to tell you how delighted we are to be for you to be with us and to tell you how much this topic ought to resonate with many members of our audience, because I think that we've talked about slavery and some of the aspects of slavery on many occasions on this show. Yes. But let's start off, Ms. Shakir, by talking about Ms. Karen Shakir. And to have you to give us some information about your background, your education, and your experiences, and some of the things that were important in terms of eventually bringing you to us this morning. And then we'll get into, by that time, the second segment, dealing specifically with the psychological impact of slavery on African Americans. Let's do it that way.
Okay, absolutely. Of course, I'm here from Nashville. I was born and raised in Nashville. I'm a major of the Africana Studies Department at Tennessee State University under Dr. Mariel Hadid. I'm a public school teacher, and I have my own school presently on Buchanan Street in North Nashville. And during the time that I was teaching in public school system, I would notice the activity between the male students and the female students, and it was a lot of negative activity that occurred, a lot of disrespect. So I often would ask the male students and the female students, how many of you come from single family homes? And I would first let them know my background, and they would feel very comfortable in talking to me and opening up. And everyone raised their hand in the entire class, and at one time I had 38 students. Everyone raised their hand except three. And those numbers were really amazing to me. And I started doing it in most of my classes and found out that the biggest problem is the home. So it led me on a long journey. And my journey was to see where the dynamics of the African-American family broke down, because something broke down somewhere. We have so many, 50% of the men, period, incarcerated are African-American men out of the total amount. And then when I heard the statistic that one in every three boys will be in jail, it was just alarming to me. And I had to come up with something to fix this problem, or at least get us on track to recognizing what the problem is, and then going in to do a reversal of what has been done on us. And that's where I am today in this particular project. I do workshops and seminars, and I'm so glad to be on your show, because we have a real serious problem in our community. The family system has broken down, and if you take it back to the actual slave trade and doing that particular process, we had atrocities that were done to us that we have never psychologically repaired. And so that's creating a lot of dissatisfaction in our community. That's creating a lot of disunity. One of the things that I want to pinpoint and talk about, in three levels, I talk about the female, her role, the male's role, and then the family as a whole. And we have to understand that even though this was so many years ago, the impact is everlasting until something comes in and reverses it. There's a letter out, a great letter, it's a theory letter, but it's called the Willie Lynch letter. And it goes into detail of actually how the process of slavery took place and what actually occurred. And during that time, the women were actually used to breed children. And that was their basically only function, because at this time in America, we were dealing with building America, we were dealing with crops, and we were dealing with making profits. So they cut off the Atlantic slave trade, and whatever slaves were in America, that's what you had. So this huge breeding process took place. It was even plantations where there was nothing going on but breeding. And women were brought in, no connection, no emotion whatsoever, and they was just used as a steer, basically, to breed. And the effects of that is that when you have children and you know that this child may be given up, may end up going for slavery. There's a disconnection that you have with that child, or over the years, or you allow yourself not to bond with that child so closely. And on the other aspect of that, the men were not able to provide and maintain for the woman. So after generations of this, they just stopped doing it.
Okay, and Mr. Cure, I think you know that it's time for our first commercial break, and we're going to take that break, and then we're going to come back following this very, very short commercial break and pick up the second segment of this particular show. Thank you, now.
Thank you.
We're talking to Ms. Karen.